This work is in collaboration with Giuseppe Pitton, who is a predoctoral student at CISA, and in collaboration with Annalisa Quaino of University of Houston. And the focus of this talk is to present you some results on some very well-known benchmark problems used to test empirical methods in the past in computational free dynamics, dealing with the bifurcation and instabilities. So the motivation of computational reduction strategies for viscous and thermal flows is to be able to get the accuracy and the reliability of higher fidelity approximation, but at a greatly reduced computational cost characterized by low order modeling. We have two different kinds of contexts, computational contexts, the real-time and the many query context. Real-time means solving a problem with an order of few seconds, and this is an input-output relationship. The many query is related with optimization, with iterative algorithm, with the physics study, when you have to solve many times the same problem in a repetitive computational setting. And we have decided to focus for this talk on bifurcation problem, so the evaluation of flow stability under perturbation and the identification of steady bifurcation points and hooked bifurcation points. Here you have an example of a flow with a perfect symmetry, and then the flow that is breaking this symmetry into different vortices. And this effect of attachment of this main stream to the wall called the ground effect. There are many possible applications in tribology, microfluid dynamics, aerodynamics, most general industrial flows, and hemodynamics. And I'm going to give you an introduction, a perspective in application in hemodynamics. And the other reason that we'd like to focus on this problem is because this problem where these problems were used a lot to benchmark numerical methods in computational free dynamics and thermal flows in the past, and also because the reduced basis method, which is the reduced order modeling technique I'm focusing, was born in the 80s to study as a continuation method to solve parametrized nonlinear problems using the continuation method. So we are translating what has been done in the structural mechanical field to free dynamics with the reduced basis method. So a general formulation of the problem, just to try to be very, very general, also maybe with scientists not familiar in computational fluid dynamics, a parametrized with formulation of Navier-Stokes equation. The parameter is mu. Mu can represent a physical or a geometrical parameter, a Reynolds number, Gretschow, Frank, Rayleigh number, or geometrical parameters, for example, the aspect ratio into a cavity. We have a range of variation of the parameter, and we want to find u as a velocity and p, the scalar pressure, as a solution of this problem reported here into very abstract formulation called weak formulation. For all of these terms, bilinear or trilinear forms, we have a different physical meaning. So we have viscous stresses for the bilinear form A, depending on the parameter. We have B is a pressure divergence terms. We have the terms bringing the derivative of the velocity with respect to time, and we have the convective field, the transport nonlinear terms here. And we have a right-hand side. In the right-hand side, you can think that this is a forcing field, and then we can see this is a very general formulation, for example, for a Rayleigh-Bernard problem. But if we are characterizing better theta can play the role of a temperature, for example. We can have a simple problem and some benchmark problem which are very well known in literature, like the Roux benchmark problem. The Gretschow number here is playing the role as a non-dimensional number, characterizing the ratio between buoyancy effect and viscous effect. We are interested also in parametrized geometry. So the idea here in this talk is very simple, because we have a reference domain and we have a parametrized domain, for example, the aspect ratio of this cavity. And the geometrical transformation is quite simple. So we have a translational terms and a rotational tensor. but in much work on reduced order modeling has been also carried out in order to parametrize complex shapes and also interfaces, multi-physics problem. So I would like to record other more general, more complex parametrization given by freeform deformation, radial basis function, transfinite mapping, and technique based on domain decomposition. So the general idea about computational reduction is reported very, very briefly in this slide. This is the classical setting. You have inputs and you want to compute a solution, a parametrized partial differential equation using high order method. And this is the timeline and the time, computational times that you need to perform, for example, this operation four times. The idea of computational reduction is that we prepare the problem, we make some offline computation. These offline computations are not depending on the parameter, and then we can have a projection. So we can use offline computing solution in order to have an online projection, giving the possibility to solve the same problem for different value of the parameter many times in the timeline with very restricted and very small computational times. The hardware idea is reported here. We use supercomputers, for example, for the computation of the so-called snapshots, so the high-order solution, and then we can perform this kind of online computational step into a laptop, into a small desktop, or also even on some new devices like the smartphone or tablets. So this is the decoupling between offline and online computational time. We are focusing more on reduced basis method, but this is one of the possibilities. In this conference, we saw many symposia, many talks devoted to other reduction techniques, PUD, proper orthogonal decomposition, EGD, digital general decomposition. So this is just one of the possible options. But the idea is that starting from a very abstract formulation of a parametrized problem, for example, for a viscous equation, this is just the solution related to velocity to simplify notation, we have to rely before on a truth approximation. So we need a classical discretization technique. That's, this can be finite element, can be spectral element method, finite difference, finite volume. The most important thing is that reduced order modeling and reduced basis method is not a computational competition with your classical and high order method, but it's a computational collaboration because you need your classical method to solve this problem for selective value of the parameter in order to get this measure, so the basis function. And calligraphic M is represented in natural degree of freedom of your high order model. The hypothesis is that from now on we can say that our truth solution is in this situation with respect to the with the exact solution. So once we have set in our truth approximation, we have to do some sampling. Sampling means selecting some value of the parameter in order to have this sample set S. For this kind of problem, there were many groups working in Europe and in the US. And for example, also from a theoretical point of view, and they proposed many sampling techniques called greedy methods, for example, or the centroid Voronoi distillation. And this is useful to have our space record construction because we have to solve this problem for the selected value of the parameter thanks to our sampling technique in order to have a hierarchical Lagrange basis. And this is what we are doing in the offline part. In the online part, we are relying again on a Galerkin projection, so the same problem, the same formulation, but now we have here a new space made up of global approximation function, and this space is the span of our previously computed snapshot, the selected solution. The most important thing is that now we are dealing with a problem of capital N's dimension, the number of basic cardinalities, so the number of basis functions, which is much smaller with respect to the degree of freedom of our high order methods. There is a preview paper, which is not the first paper, of course, on the topic, but a quite broad paper in introducing this kind of methodology, published in 2008 on ARM, Archives Computational Methods in Engineering. So the heuristic idea, just for this methodology, is that if you are going to represent a functional space into a Cartesian and a 3D space, we can imagine that we have this manifold of parametrized solution, and the black dots are representative of the selected snapshot for the selected value of the parameter. the reduced order modeling is approximating this manifold or parametrized solution with the red dotted line. And what we are interested in is also to keep the error under control, so to have sharp a posteriori error estimation in order to control the distance between these two approximated manifolds. Another important thing is that we are relying on this kind of not only offline online computational strategy, but also the fact that we can decouple our parameterized operator into a sum of parameter independent operators, the linear forms in this case, and theta coefficient depending, for example, on the parameter. Now we can go to the two approximation, so we can use a higher order approximation. In this case, it's the same problem as before in the approximation setting for the operator also. And for example, this time we are relying on the Lagrange spectral method. We have used to compute our snapshot the NEC 5000 software, open source software proposed by Paul Fisher at Harvard National Laboratories. But the most important thing is that we are relying on the spectral accuracy and on all the properties provided by the spectral element method. Concerning the reduced basis method, here we have the same formulation, but in this case we will have a solution in that is going to be found in this span of reduced basis spaces. And to characterize this reduced basis space, we have to spend a few words about approximation stability for this problem. The first idea is to build the reduced basis spaces for the velocity using the velocity snapshot, and the reduced basis spaces for the pressure using the pressure basis pressure snapshot. But of course, we know that this is not sufficient because we have also to fulfill an equivalent parameter in subcondition, the breadth in subcondition, and this. In order to fulfill this condition, we have to enrich properly or to stabilize our problem. And approximation stability is needed. The first approaches that we have proposed were the supervised enrichment of the velocity spaces. So these velocity spaces was enriched with additional velocity fulfilling this condition. This is one of the options. This is a bit expensive, and maybe for this kind of problem, today we are going to propose the layer projection, another way of introducing to guarantee the approximation stability for this problem. So the idea is that we are using an Helmholtz layer decomposition, and given a vector field, we can decompose it into a sum of a gradient of a potential and another vector field V, which is divergence free. In this way, we can get rid of the pressure and the divergence terms, and so we can use for our problem just divergence-free basis. The final idea, is that the velocity will be given as a weighted combination of a previously computed basis function, and this vector of weighting is coming from the solution of the Galerkin, so the system solving the Galerkin projection. And we can, of course, recover the pressure if we need. A remark about this, because if we have a geometrical dependency, the snapshot will be divergence free only on the original domain. So on the reference domain, we will have this kind of div free condition, which is a transformation due to the parametrization. So with the RA projection, we can guarantee also the fact that also in the reference domain, we will have divergence free velocity. And after this, we can also introduce a Gram-Schmidt orthogonalization for the basis function in order to improve the performances and to guarantee a better algebraic stability. What about the sampling procedure? For the sampling procedure, the sampling technique, I have to spend a few words because there were many methods available and under development, and I just would like to mention the greedy, the silly case, and also the POD greedy. And for this problem, we are relying on the centroidal Voronoi tessellation introduced by Bulger and Wolfsburger in 2006. And the main idea is that we are sampling both steady state and time-dependent snapshot. And the idea is that we have a triangulation in the parametric space, and we are going to compute this distance function rho, such that we have a measure on the vertices between the true solution and the one that we are able to approximate thanks to our methodology with the already selected snapshot. So The final idea is that we are selecting a new point in the very center of the triangle such that we are minimizing this condition. Maybe this graphical interpretation is a bit better if we have, for example, two parameters, the aspect ratio of the cavity and the Gresham number. At the beginning you have this point which is selected random. Then you compute the residual of the approximation of the triangle, and you can find that the maximum sum of rho is reported here, so we will have the computation for the next snapshot on this body center of this triangle. And you continue in this way after just sampling the sum of the rho function, the residual on the triangle. This is a weighted residual, that's why in this case the body center is almost on the side, and this is important because in this case, since we are keeping together steady and unsteady snapshot, we can have a better balance of the two. And the weight usually is for the body center is based on the residual. This is just an example of the distribution of the selected snapshot between the Grashof and in the aspect ratio parametric space. You can see that for lower Grashof we have the selection of the steady snapshot, and the geometry is playing an important role, and then you have the selection of the time-dependent snapshot for a higher Grashof number. When we have to deal with time-dependent problems like the one we are proposing, there is also the possibility to compute a reduced order modeling in time. So once we have selected the value of the parameter, we can perform a proper orthogonal decomposition in time, freezing the parameter. This is a classical procedure, well known, is the classical POD procedure, so the formulation of the problem and the construction of a correlation matrices for different snapshot in time, and then the solution of an alien problem in order to have the corresponding eigenvalue and eigenvector, and then the construction of basis function in time. This is allowing us to improve and to get better performance for the basis construction. What about the certification of reduced basis method? In order to better approximate the manifold, we have to rely on error band, which should be not too expensive to be computed, and to measure the error between the truth and the reduced basis method, and we call this error bound delta. So we are relying on the giant shoulder, on the Brezzi-Rapp parallel theory, 1981 mathematics. There are some development based on this for a steady Stokes problem, for the steady Navier-Stokes at the beginning of the 80s by also Karen De Roy, Tony Patera, De Paris, Andrea Maruzzoni, more recently. And then the time-dependent problem, the Business problem with David Knezevich, and now also the space-time formulation proposed by Patera, Jano, and Urban for time-dependent Navier-Stokes. The idea is that we are relying on this space-time, since the final t is not so long, and the Reynolds number or the Grashof number are still reasonable. Concerning the Brezzi-Rapp theory, we have to compute some ingredients appearing in this formulation that I'm reporting now here. So we will have the computation of the continuity constant related with, for example, the Sobolev constant, and the dual log of the residual, and also a lower bound for a beta super based on the threshold relatives of the operator. This is still an open field in the computational point of view because there are many challenges and many groups are working also on separate aspects to improve some of these computational points. But in any case, everything is relying on this idea in the space-time formulation. What about now the branching prediction? We would like to test this problem, for example, for nonlinear problems, also trying to be able to capture fine physical details and also non-unic solution in after branching. So the idea is that at the beginning we are studying the steady bifurcation, introducing the steady version of the Navier-Stokes operator. We are taking the threshold derivatives of the convection terms, and we have so this linear operator that we indicated with tau. And we introduce a reduced basis formulation for this operator with the pre-post multiplication of the snapshot, and we solve this eigenvalue, the eigenvalue problem related with this operator. This has been something that has been already introduced not in the reduced order modeling by Galdi and then more recently by Cliff. And the idea is that in the presence of a bifurcation, we have the small real part of the value in the absolute value is crossing the zero. So this can be seen as a bifurcation alarm, bifurcation detection. And this also is, we are able to recapture this also in the reduced order modeling. This is the spectrum of the real and imaginary part of the eigenvalue, and the minimum one is just crossing the zero here. If you do a comparison with the previous results from 1999 by Jeff, by Josef and Zari, we can see that they were crossing the zero at the Grashof, which was 31, and this is exactly also what we can rebuild using a reduced order model. So we have used this problem as a benchmark in order to be able to have a further elements, so the bifurcation, the detecting tool based on the eigenvalue calculation and analysis. We can do the same in the RCD, in the RCD case, so we have to introduce a flow, the period omega for our flow. In this case, we are introducing the linearization of the full Navier-Stokes operator, and we are trying to superimpose the steady state and then a perturbation. And we have to compute another eigenvalue problem, and the real part of sigma is an indication of our instability. So at one point, we will have this perturbation characterized by this sigma eigenvalue with the real part greater than zero, and we are going to, and we are not damping this this kind of perturbation, but we are moving to a further time periodic state. And so this is what we can do also introducing an equivalent eigenvalue problem with our reduced basis spaces in order to extract this kind of information. Just to show you some results, we are going to simplify a bit the previous formulation of the problem using a prime number equal to zero, and so we have these forcing terms as a linear terms in x with the Grashof number in the vertical direction. The range of the Grashof is between 50,000 and 1 million, and the aspect ratio is going from 2 to 10. And this is a well-known benchmark problem studied by Jeff and also proposed by the GAM as a benchmark problem in the buoyancy-driven cavity. And this is what we can have. So it's a parametrized problem changing the aspect ratio. So we have many different physical solutions, one roll, two rolls, four roles in the steady case, but also we have some unsteady time periodic solution reported here with the three roles. So this is a problem with very different physical details, and we are going to approximate with the reduced number of basis functions, putting together steady and unsteady solution, and of course using a continuation method led by our tools for the detection of the bifurcation. And the computational time that I'm showing usually would need more than 24 hours on supercomputers for high order, but we can rebuild this in a few minutes on a personal computer. So this is basically the idea. Grashof and the velocity at the selected point. So you have the first branch at one point with one roll. At one point, the solution is no more unique because we have also this two-roll solution. And then here, again, we have also another bifurcation because we have the three-roll solution to the bifurcation. So this was, for us, a benchmark for our methodology for new solution and branching, and the detection also of this branching according to the results already presented by Jeff. The other idea is that we can also build the stability diagram detecting the off bifurcation, the steady bifurcation, putting together steady and unsteady problem, and reducing a bit the dimension of the aspect ratio. This is the final result of the stability region, rebuilt with the reduced basis method, but relying also on the higher fidelity method as a comparison. So we can see that we have the stability region for one roll flow, for the two roll flow, the steady and the hope bifurcation, and for the three rolls flow. You can see that sometimes for regression and aspect ratio the solution is not unique, and this can be detected. And also, for example, that we have the stability of one roll flow for all the aspect ratio for a Grashof number big enough. And for example, if you want the two roll solution, is not available for some aspect ratio, but from aspect ratio greater than sensitivity intervention. So this is the idea. The possibility of a many query solution depend parametrized solution to detect bifurcation or instability limit, stability limit, using the reduced order modeling. This is a comparison between the oscillation solution or a time trial solution or reduced order modeling and a higher order modeling. So you can see that the amplitude and the phase are quite good in the agreement, and this is the visual comparison between the two solutions, the higher order one with the spectral methods of order 20 and the reduced order solution using this as basis function. The perspective is application for this kind of effect, and for example, this is a leading motivation of the work carried out in collaboration with Annalisa Quain, University of Houston, and medical doctor she's collaborating with. So the mitral valve regurgitation. This is a sort of valvular heart disease. There is a sort of blood leakage, and so there is a blood going into an inverse direction for the from the ventricle to the left atrium, and so the leakage of the mitral valve. Here we have some echocardiographic data, and you can see two different kinds of jet, the central jet and eccentric jet. And this eccentric jet is characterized by the quand effect. If there is the quand effect, medical doctors are not able to detect properly the volume of blood characterized by this mitral regurgitation, and so they are not able to detect the pathology. The quand effect was already well known in aerodynamics because it was used also in aeronautics to improve some performances of some type during the taking off and the landing, but this is also one of the biggest challenges for the mitral regurgitation in echocardiography. And here we have just a very simplified model for a mitral valve with a sudden expansion. You can see that this is the solution with the Moffat eddies without knowing what is the inlet and the outflow. Then here we have the symmetric solution with the two vortex and the breaking of the solution after bifurcation with the coagulant effect. And this is another branch again with a reduced basis for this kind of application. Reynolds as a function of the velocity in the mean line. You can see that at one point you have the breaking of the symmetry, so we have a steady bifurcation. And what also was a bit surprising to us is that we are able, with higher order methods, for example spectral method, to recover the symmetric solution, even if this is very unstable. And we are doing also this in 3D, and we are trying to understand how the quand effect is delayed or is disappearing concerning, for example, the three-dimensional effect or other geometrical parametrization. If we have an uneven orifice, we can parameterize the position of the orifice, and also, for example, introducing free structure interaction on the mitral valve model. So we are interested in this kind of problem, but we think that we are providing a computational reduction tools also to detect the quand effect in hemodynamics application, and also the detection of bifurcation and instability limit using reduced order modeling is possible. Of course, it was a big work also in the past, because we are working on reduced order modeling in CFD in the last 11 years, so I've talked to many people with my very fruitful collaboration in the past. And I would like also to advertise the European Union Model Reduction Network in the framework of the transdisciplinary reaction of cost, European cooperation in sensitive technology. If you are interested, you can still join this European network. And of course, I would like also to spend the last few seconds to advertise the new Applied Mathematics Division created at CISAS, Samantha, directed by Antonio De Simone. This is not only a new multidisciplinary research group, but there are also some joint initiatives like a new PhD program in mathematical analysis, modeling and application, and also new master in high-performance computing, and in September they are starting the operation of a new supercomputer center with a 100 teraflop in Miramare. And I would like to thank again ECCOMAS, and I would like to thank all the audience for the attention, and show you just a greeting card from the Trieste Gulf, from Sissa to the city. And thanks again.
Thank you very much. Is there a point on? Do you have a chance? Thank you very